right. I guess we haven't formally met before. The reason I need to talk with you, Jason...
Hooray! Jason's finally getting some attention!
It's Jimmy, actually. My name is Jimmy, PC Principal.
Aww. Nobody's gonna get that reference anyway. Welcome, dear all, to Friendly Faces Era! Sponsored content kickstarts the ad arc with PCP being angry over the use of the word retarded in the school newspaper. School newspaper, eh? Well, there goes another one of my fanfic ideas. However, it turns out that Jimmy is the editor, and the principal is somewhat afraid to use his aggressive tactics on him. This is a reveal done well. Jimmy wasn't especially active this season, and usually every year there is at least one episode centered on one of the handicapped kids. Pity that Timmy only got a cameo, but he had a big role last year. Besides, it makes sense for our comedian to be the one to finally break PCP, since the latter can't think him to be anything other than a victim. Well played. I like the episode both in concept and in execution, but I don't think it compares well to the last two standalones. Perhaps what drags it down is that I'll have to look at it as the first act of a three-parter. Speaking of which, I would like to notice this is the first time Jimmy has been the main character of a multi-part story. He remains the most consistent and most active player throughout the finale, being a great adversary to PC Principal as well as finally acknowledging Nathan as an enemy. Sponsored content, as well as its two follow-ups, made me appreciate Nathan a lot more as a character. I found him much more compelling as a supporting villain in the storyline than as a comic relief villain to Jimmy in his previous episodes. Maybe it's a creepy voice, but for some reason he really fits into this role. One notable background character I would like to mention is Tom Pussylicker, the previous anchor for Channel 4 News who has not been seen since Season 12. It's a very nice detail one wouldn't usually notice, but they used him nonetheless. Speaking of missing characters, Principal Victoria finally returns. Or I guess it's just Victoria now. Not sure why she has a limp though, but since PCP threatened to break Jimmy's legs once, I guess that might be related?
Mr. Garrison, I wasn't fired. I was replaced.
Oh, you're just trying to make yourself look better. After her replacement with PCP, I was wondering if she had a story to come ever since the beginning of the season. Victoria's role in this arc is much better handled here than in the payoff, but I still appreciate it for what it is, even if her lines tend to be needlessly cryptic and vague. Her introduction also touches upon Garrison's presidential campaign, which seems to be going well. Truth be told, I'm not sure if bringing the Garrison gang back for the finale was necessary at all with everything else going on, but I understand why they were brought back now instead of just next season. The idea of South Park having serialization is still pretty new, so it's better for everything to come full circle a bit in the finale, even at the cost of poor pacing later on. It may be flawed, but it's better than the outrage of the audience. Again, I'm just really happy so much time was devoted to secondary or even tertiary characters. I realize I'm talking a lot about characters instead of judging the story, but this episode is very character-driven. I would like to draw attention to PC Principal and how my perception of him has changed during the season. In Stunning and Brave, I viewed him as a one-note character who was just there to represent an ideology. While the latter might still be partly true, there are several differences that I've drawn between him and the other frat boys I would like to highlight. He is shown to be much more idealistic than the others, caring more about doing what he thinks is right than indulging in the hedonistic pleasures his frat mates do. Hell, has he ever been shown drinking? The closest we ever see him to crushing puss is when he collects consent forms, which by the way is a hilarious idea, but we never actually see him picking up women himself. Randy, in a way, is the very opposite. When he pledges at first, he only cares about drinking, trying to justify it with the PC ideas. But then, he comes to care more about the changes in South Park, being the only member of PC Delta to have lived in South Park before the PC Revolution. Both he and PC Principal become bullies in the process, which leads to the former's fight with Sharon.
Your little meetings you go to at night to discuss social justice? It's just a way to pick up on young women?
Two syllables, Sharon. Two Park. Anyway, the Leslie reveal was handled very well. I find it an excellent choice that they chose a background character who has been around since Season 9 instead of a new character model for her. We know she's not someone who's moved into South Park during the Hofford's craze, she's been here forever. Who knows what other background characters are at? And with what happens in the following two episodes, well, without giving too much away, this might play a part later on. Let's see how everything develops in truth and advertising.
Everyone likes me.
Safe space.
People don't judge me and haters don't hate in my safe space.
Your safe space.
Bully.
look and you will see there's a very select crowd in your safe space.
My safe space.